They'll be calling you a radical. We have a lot to talk about. What you want to be the truth, what you think is the truth, what your dogma has dug into you to be the truth, your hypnotized state. You couldn't tell a rumor from fact. You couldn't tell right from right. It's like this. I've said for years, it's Albert Belle swinging Mark McGwire swinging Albert Belle's bat while riding Lance Armstrong's bike. Now we have to add, it's Mark McGwire swinging Albert Belle's bat, riding Lance Armstrong's bike while singing Stairway to Heaven. You've been conned lock, stock, barrel. You wouldn't know. Really, you're going to wait for confirmation. Now, let's talk about the facts. Let's talk about the reality of Fukushima. Let's talk about the difference in your mind and your sickness. And I don't give a fuck about what you want things to be or what you think things are, because you're ignorant. The mass of the population is, it's a fact. It's grotesque. I don't care what you think of me. I don't give a fuck about your ridiculous keyboard fucking one-liner bullshit fucking stupid childish comments. Sophisticated comments, intelligent data, fucking things that matter. Oh yeah, that's what I give a fuck about. The facts. I've been all over this from day one. Remember, I am the only person on the face of the fucking earth who's reported this 100% inaccurate in detail from the inception. Called it format. Now let's talk about number four. Before you lose your attention span. Before your attention span, because it's as long as your dick, which you don't know how to use anyway. You traded your sexuality, you traded everything in a long fucking time ago. You gave up your fucking humanity. Oh, I heard a rumor. Colin Powell said that fucking Saddam Hussein had weapons of mass destruction. I heard a rumor that Osama bin Laden did 9/11. I heard a fucking rumor that Jessica Lynch fucking fighting off Al-Qaeda in a fucking spur of the fucking was this great, incredible fucking bravery soldier like Audie Murphy. I heard a rumor that Pat Tillman fighting off fucking, I heard a rumor he was fucking fighting him off, whatever, fucking in a rage of glory, killed 9 billion fucking Al-Qaeda. I heard a rumor that fucking gold was going to $5,000 an ounce by 2013. I heard a rumor that silver was going to fucking $300 an ounce in 2013. I heard a rumor on Fox. I heard all these rumors on Fox that the Dow was crashing, going to zero, that Glenn Beck said sell at 6,500. Fox News said buy. I heard all these rumors. I heard a rumor that Obama was a socialist. I heard a rumor that that George Bush really won the election. I heard a rumor that the New York Times sticks up and respects for their own of the hypocrite Megan Rice. You dumb fuckers don't know the rumor between a fucking rumor and the fact. You took all those for facts. Every one of those for fact. All of them rumors. The fact. The fact. The fact. Sheep. I don't give a fuck what any of you fuckers think of me. I don't give a fuck. I give a fuck about trying to stay alive. I care about my kids. I care about my grandchildren. You dumb fuckers don't. You don't give a fuck. You wouldn't know a fucking Picasso and a fucking Chevy right. You'd go to yard sale, find a real Picasso. You'd take it home, paint red paint over the fucker. That's who this country is. And it's fucking proven. If this is not fucking commentary, this is a doc. This is documentary. In whole. In fact. Fact. On the moment of the shake, not only were three reactors put in full blown-out meltdown, the fourth reactor spent fuel pools cracked and water leaked out. Now, here, class, when a spent fuel pool, what is a spent fuel pool? Nuclear reactors were never set up to have fucking waste stored on site. Oh, they told us for years they hadn't. They fucking lied the whole time. It's been nothing but a fucking lie, and you guys went along with it because it makes you feel comfortable while you die of fucking cancer, on your fucking, taking five fucking pills a day, hypnotized by the box. You got no humanity anyway. What do you give a fuck if you die? What do you care? Humanity fucking left you a long fucking time ago. Not me, fuckers. Okay, so the water goes off spent fuels assemblies. Can they put water back over it, class? It's like I used to ask my class. Class, can a commodity rise in one country while going down simultaneously in the same country, like gold or silver? Yeah, it's the currency. Oh, Obama's a socialist. I mean, it's fucking blows my mind. Yeah, and that fucking Cheney and Bush and Rumsfeld were humanity. Barry Antoinette let them eat. They're all on the same fucking team. Okay, the spent fuel pool number four goes dry. They put water back over it. Does that work? No. No, you can't turn it off. It's called nuclear fission. That's what we've said the whole fucking time about nuclear. There's no answer for the fucking waste, and there never will be an answer for the waste. It's a cash cow, sucking cow, Berkeley fucking Livermore money fucking. It's the Manhattan Project gone a fucking muck. The fucking dollar was crashed between 2003. Fuck, your fucking money got fucking wiped out. You don't even fucking know it. You just fucking slowly fucking numb. Fucking poison powered you. I mean, it's outrageous, the ignorance of that. Yeah, this video shows up with some fucking lighting in it. What's the lighting? I don't know. Oh, it just happened to be, you know. It is what it is. If I don't put that video up, this debate's not even happening. Jen and I found that fucker. You fucking fainting goats can't find your fucking ass. It's outrageous. There's three full-court meltdowns over there. So here, listen, class. Here, kiddies. It's pathetic. The American pop is pathetic, but it's killing all of us. Your fucking ignorance is a choice. A lazy, it's just like this, class. Okay. To tell the truth is to die. Think about this. Dan Rather, the greatest journalist of he told the truth. What happened to Dan Rather, the greatest journalist of an entire fucking generation? He told the truth. Oh, he got fired for saying George Bush was a fucking draft dodger when George Bush was... You know, fuckers don't want the fucking truth. You can't handle the fucking truth. You don't fucking need the truth. You just fucking lay down your life and gave up your humanity. Because of ignorance, ignorance closes you in. You don't even know what humanity is. Because your mind's never been broad enough. Is it your fault? I don't know. Tariffs. Working too long? I don't know. Three full courts. So what do you think all those tanks are there building over there? What, do you just think that's because they look nice? What do you think? Oh, Reuters now reports fucking they're dumping water. Oh, I'm going to listen to Reuters. We're waiting for confirmation from Fox News. Oh, my God. I mean, it's so outrageous. There's three full court meltdowns, and the four pools went fucking dry. They refilled them. That's a fact. That's a fucking fact. We know. I've been reporting four on fire. Look, it's like this, class. They're on fucking fire. 1, 2, 3, 4, and most likely 5 and 6. They've been on fire the whole time. Oh, we can't see flames shooting up. Fire trucks aren't fucking racing in. Oh, really? You can drive a fire truck in there? You know what the fucking temperature is there? So, the fire, it's... Oh, all fires, water put out? What are you, in the third fucking grade? I've come to learn, even the physicists, the science world, it's the third fucking grade. Well, we haven't heard anything from Fox. We haven't heard anything from Barry Antoinette. We haven't heard anything from Gene McCarthy. We haven't heard anything on the fucking marine biologists at Berkeley. Even when they do fucking tell you. I mean, it's just like this. Somebody's put a question mark. They started upping in on 4, 3, 11. Yeah! There were prosecution hearings over there. In the prosecution hearings, TEPCO admitted they started dumping the fucking contaminated water into the Pacific Ocean on 4-3-11. Oh, I didn't hear that on Fox. I didn't see that on Zero Hedges' vlog. I didn't see that on any of these fuckheads' vlogs. I didn't see any of that. Okay, I don't give a fuck what you fucking think of me. I'm here to repack that. I'm here to try to fight for my kids and my fucking grandkids' fucking life. I'll do it on my own. I'll do it in critical condition. I'll do it fucking broke. I'll be the only one on the face of the earth that tells this fucking story in critical accuracy. I don't give a fuck. And I don't need your fucking credit. Because I'll get life. I'll get fucking life. Because I'm doing what everyone should fucking be doing. There's a trade-off for fucking life. You have to give back to fucking humanity. That's why you all fucking die. And when you get cancer, you all fucking die. Because you have no humanity. The natives had it right. This is a fucking dog and pony show from hell. Okay, they're on fire. You can't see flames. You can't see it. It's invisible. It's smellless. It's so fucking hot. So what's in their answer? When the plumes went up, they blew up. They blew over North America. It is fucking much more dangerous to live in San Francisco, California, in fucking Ogden, Utah, in fucking New York City, than Scotland, fucking England, than it is to live in Tokyo. The wind was blowing out. You could go in denial. You could think you're above this all you want. On day fucking 6, they made the decision to dump water on it. What does the water do on it? Does it keep it cool? On the heat source off the top. It knocks down the heat source on the top of the fucking reactor. Are they underneath it? Obviously. Fuck, they're staging tens of thousands, 8,000 workers dead. I have more information than you'll ever know. And yeah, someday I'll write a fucking book. But it's not fucking time. This is unfolding. This is a fucking epic. The fucking knowledge I have through this fight, I could tell you stories about Fukushima to blow all your fucking minds. The most intellect of the intellect. Because you guys weren't paying attention, and I fucking was. all the way down to my fucking bone marrow. Sweet are the uses of adversity. I will read this to you fucking fainting fucking goats. This is who I am. This is what I am. I wrote this the 30-year mark of the fucking death of fucking John Lennon when this madness fucking went into earnest. And you fuckers become hypnotized. Remember in 1982 in Central Park? I was there. I was there. 86% of the population. I want you to just think about this. 60% of the American population still to this day believe that Lance Armstrong was on it. And you do know it was funded by the CIA. They had the Irish maid figure back on it. Why would they do American propaganda? Oh, to fool you fainting fucking goats. I see post-ignorance as a pure art movement, and the concept of art as self, and the concept of art as culture, and the concept of the people are culture, and the concept that inspiration influenced our great historical artists, like Van Gogh, Amelie, like poets' reference to Kandinsky, like Monet's to the sunlight, morning, dawn, winter, fall, spring. It is influenced by the involvements of the time. My look at culture and art there as today, economic theory, pop culture, Or more reality, the lack thereof, the mind of seeing when others for uncognitive reason do not see. Everyone saw light from millenniums. Everyone saw a simple line from millenniums. Everyone saw eclectic color from millenniums. It is more per se than the artist. Monet saw the light. Millet saw the struggle. Van Gogh saw the line. Smithson saw the simplicity of the line and shape against the landscape. Kandinsky saw the election of color and shape. Pollock saw the color of dynamics in motion, but much more than that, they saw decades ahead of the truth. Their minds were fact and truth. Their minds were strong enough to act upon what they understood when all others did not understand, not yet. They had heart, strong backs, and knew how to work. They were the purification of ambition, intelligent, education, smooth with work ethic. I visualized and have for over two decades via my Hawken trial, via my keyboard, via my paintbrush, via my $3 throwaway cardboard camera, via my flip camera, video camera, via my soapbox, YouTube, via my websites is this: poetic injustice to the entire world, wars without provocation, pain without a crime, love without an artistic spirit, ignorance with a club, a big club. As a counter, what I have termed neo-ignorance is post-ignorance. I see post-ignorance like this: as a movement in pure intellectualism, in a broad intellectualism, not I know how art history, not I know how to draw like a camera, not I know how to interpretate, not I know how to incorporate, but I know culture, I know environments in the more exposed manner, I know economics, I know geopolitics, I know metaphors, good and bad, I know struggle and what it feels like to be stolen in wealth, artistic and benevolent. Look, I'm not here for the fucking masses. This is quantity, not quality, and everybody that you think is quality is not quality. You know, maybe you can wait for fucking Colin Powell to tell you, give you confirmation that this is killing you. Maybe you can fucking wait for Barry Antoinette. Maybe you can wait for fucking Hillary Westinghouse, Rodham Clinton. Maybe you can make for the Bush crime fucking family can come back, you know? You guys couldn't tell a fucking Picasso slapped you in your fucking face. You don't know the fucking, you don't know the rumor from a fact because you're so confused. This is one confused bunch of motherfuckers. This whole country, beyond fucking confused, it's ignorance. Ignorance is a lazy, lazy, sickening fucking choice. Y'all chose it. Your fucking two-bit fucking punk-ass fucking third-grade comments. You're fucking talking behind my back shit fucking like a bunch of little fucking bitches. I don't even watch you other fuckers' videos. I don't. Yeah. And I've done this for free with no support, with nobody. Whatever. What the fuck ever. You know? No, I don't fucking need fucking anyone. Except for the fucking loved ones that are circled around me and our small fucking spark gun. That's all I need. And that's all it needs to change culture. We need to get to fucking people in power and people that fucking matter and people can't. Because you dumb fuckers, oh fuck, we hate fucking politicians. We hate politicians. You don't even know who your congressman is. You have no fucking clue, rhyme, nor reason. You go along like a bunch of fainting goats with knee-jerk fucking reactions with your own fucking dogma and you made it up because you have no humanity. You gave your humanity away a long time ago. Populism is dead. It died 3/11/11. It's fucking dead. You're just in fucking denial to fucking understand it and to fucking know it. And you think, oh, I'm fucking smart. My mommy told me I was. Your mommy told you? Your mommy told you? Ooh, I really know about this stuff. This fucking asshole calls me. I want to do another radio interview with you. Oh, it looks like three. Shut the fuck up on that. I'm fucking sick of fucking the whole fucking dynamic of these fucking fainting goats. I don't give a fuck if I get 10 billion views or 6. I don't care. I'm trying to fucking organize a small group of people that can fucking save you dumb fuckers from yourselves. Because you refuse to fucking do it. Fuck, you don't know truth from fucking fiction. You don't know fact from fucking rumor. Fuck. So fucking disgusting what this fucking country's done to all of us. It's us. It isn't politicians. It's not fucking bankers. It's fucking us. And boy, they named us right. Baby, 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 old baby boomers.